created by happy accident when an ice cream vendor at the 1904 World's Fair ran out of serving cups. A nearby waffle maker came to the rescue by rolling his waffles into a cone.
This Vancouver-based company has been perfecting the art of making waffle cones for two generations.
Into the mixer goes water, sugar, flour, and a mixture of canola oil and soy lecithin, a binding agent made from soybeans.
Batter making isn't as easy as it looks. Each batch has to be exactly 17 degrees Celsius, or the cones will be inconsistent.
In the summertime, the flour will be a lot warmer. We have to cool the batter down with the water to even out the temperature.
Each batch of batter is 50 liters, which is enough to keep the production line going for 45 minutes.
The mixture is lifted and poured into a hopper, which feeds the Jupiter 45. The Jupiter 45 is a one-stop cone cooking and rolling machine, and it's the bigger, better brother of his last setup.
Our old machine, the Jupiter 19, we were lucky to produce 3 cases an hour. Today, we're able to do 12 plus cases an hour. It makes a big difference.
From the Jupiter's hopper, a predetermined amount of batter is pumped onto a baking chain of waffle irons.
The tops close on the batter to cook both sides at once.
The waffle irons are connected together like tank tracks and are heated by gas flame.
After 50 seconds, freshly cooked waffles are released, but to make them handheld, a rotating arm guides them to a cone shaper.
The wafer is inserted into a metal cone shape, and a rapidly spinning piston rolls the waffle neatly into a cone.
The perfect shape for holding your ice cream.
This machine can produce 3,000 cones per hour, and King Cone will manufacture up to 30,000 a day.
Jens stands by to ensure that nothing holds up production of his baby.
Even though you've seen it running fantastic today, believe me, there's days where it just is a nightmare. It's given me gray hairs over the years.
Oh, that's parenting for you.